Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're going to the jungles of Guyana for some extreme freshwater fishing. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, plus go on an adventure of a lifetime, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television.
We got a wreck. Pato. Pato. We call it pato.
Electric eel, boy.
Huh?
Electric eel.
Wait.
Really?
No, what?
And then I miss it.
Till it's a little bit.
Yeah.
What is it?
Electric eel under the log that I shot just now.
So why aren't we afraid of the electric eels?
Well, once you don't go close to them, then don't come close to you. Then just stay one stable place.
Okay, I feel much better.
We're in the Guyana Highlands on the upper Essequibo River, one of the most remote locations in South America, and home to an incredible variety of sport fish species, including peacock bass, piranha, payara, arowana, catfish, and giant arapaima. But right now, we have catfish bait, so let's go catfishing.
So I got some Procure catfish cocktail. Yummy.
In this 20-foot deep hole, there are so many piranha, it's a wonder that the catfish can muscle their way in. But they do.
All right, we got a catfish on. Oh man, it's a nice one. Oh man, he's just digging down there. Oh, it's a big one.
Like 30 to 40 pounds.
This red-tail cat is probably not that heavy. It's just a juvenile, with full-grown adults approaching the 100-pound mark. A fun and interesting fish to catch, but not really an example of the giants this region of South America can produce.
Oh, he's a talker. He's talking to me. Yeah, nice cat.
On the way in, we were able to visit the Guyana National Museum in the capital city of Georgetown. It takes a minute to accept that the giant sloth was real. It's extinct now, but ancient humans did live side by side with this jungle giant, as well as the giant arapaima.
Rather round, aren't they?
So, yeah, do they hit artificial lures or mostly live bait?
Lures.
In fact, the Essequibo River is likely the only place in the world where anglers have a legitimate chance of hooking a 300 to 400 pound giant arapaima on artificial lures. And regardless, where we're going, no bait fishing for arapaima is allowed. After an hour and a half flight from Georgetown, we've landed in the middle of the Guyana Highlands. And now it's about a two-hour boat ride up the Upper Essequibo through this unspoiled jungle to the only sign of civilization in the area, King William Lodge, our home for our extreme jungle fishing adventure. Located on an island within the Upper Essequibo River, the third longest river in South America, King William Lodge gives us exclusive and unprecedented access to the upper river and the surrounding jungle, one of the great remaining unspoiled natural treasures of the world. We're surrounded by great fishing, especially if you like throwing artificial lures such as rip baits and topwater plugs for incredibly hard-fighting peacock bass. But be careful and always wear glasses.
Yikes. Guess we've done that with that hit, huh?
Our morning alarm clock. We got some howler monkeys pretty close to the camp, probably about 50 yards away up in a large tree here. Kind of spooky sounding.
Welcome to a magical morning in the deep jungle of the steamy Guyana Highlands. I'm Justin Wolf. During the rainy season, the Essequibo River rises to a level that fills nearby ponds and gives fish the ability to migrate in and out of those ponds. The giant arapaima is one species that inhabits the ponds of the Essequibo. During the dry season, the ponds are isolated within the thick jungle, so boats must be portaged to the ponds, which in some cases are no more than 3 or 4 feet deep. It's just hard to believe that fish up to 6 to 8 feet long and maybe 300 to 400 pounds are to be found in these small blackwater ponds.
Bubbles out there. Yeah, I already see some bubbles out here. These arapaima are air breathers, and they'll leave a trail of bubbles. And then you want to fish beyond them and get those baits right in front of them. So the lure our guide chose first was a white Savage glider, triple X hooks, split rings. What happens is these fish come up and they breathe and then they go down and they suspend. So it's a perfect lure for that. It gets right in front of their face, just twitching, not really, you know, swimming it too hard. You just want to twitch it in front of them. So our captain's making up some wire leaders right now with some fish field extra strong split rings. These arapaima's got a really, he said, sandy mouth, so it's a really rough mouth. So you need wire leader, at least 100 pound.
You guys, we're going to be very quiet, okay? Quiet enough. You cast out?
Yeah.
And like, wait 3 seconds for sinking. And then put two reel in, yeah, so that the bait will go.
Today we're not able to draw a strike, but with 18 ponds available, we'll hit some fresh water the next morning. But for this afternoon, let's head out to the main river where there's lots of opportunities to catch fish and to see the sights. Ozzy, our captain, wanted to show us some petroglyphs created by his Amerindian ancestors. Monkeys and various other figures and symbols adorn the rocks, including a mermaid. I suppose if there was a place for mermaids to exist, it would be here, because these waters are so full of life, you just never know what's going to pop up.
We get full service here. One of my favorite lures was out there, got snagged way out there. He went out there and got it. These guys are great. Yeah. No, nothing bit you. No bites. How'd it go for you guys today so far?
It's been pretty good. You know, we started off this morning and just banged a whole bunch of peacocks, like right off the bat, some pretty nice ones. Then we moved along. caught some piranha. We had stopped at a deep hole there, and we baited up and dropped down like instantly, man. I caught about a 20-pound red cat.
Nice.
Yeah, it was nice. Good fight.
Yeah, so I had something big on this thing, but it got away. Too bad.
Castmaster always comes
through. Castmaster comes through, yeah.
Yeah. I swear I catch more fish on those things. They're the catch-all lure.
They are.
And they cast a mile.
Barracuda, snook, catches everything. Barracuda. Freshwater barracuda. Freshwater barracuda. Look at this nice tail, nice little orange tail. Scaled, pointy mouth. Ooh, strong too. Crankbaits are working really well. Oh, I wish I would have brought a whole box of them. Yeah, I didn't have much room for a lot of tackle because of weight concerns. But man, they love them. I wish I would have brought some Aruco shad from Spro.
Fishing the upper Essequibo River in the Guyana Highlands of South America, and we've just found a pile of peacock bass in a tributary battle.
Oh, man. It's literally every cast right now. So fun. These fish just hammer it. There he is. Oh, that's a good one. We got a little problem here already. We got some bent hooks out here. 3 or 4x extra strongs is what you need here. Oh yeah.
We could do this all day long, but let's take a break and try trolling a lipless crankbait just to see what happens.
So what we're doing is we're just trolling in between islands here. Got a big rattle trap bouncing in half. I just got nailed by something. Here it is. Looks like a piranha. Oh, big piranha. Man, imagine a dozen of those eating on you. Oh yeah, little predator gel. Oh, there he is. Oh yeah.
The next morning, we're on the river early to make a fairly long run to one of the larger ponds, which not only has a good number of giant arapaima, but also arowana, another species that reaches trophy size in Guyana.
There's arowana in this pond, so we want to use top water. What's the minimum water?
Wanna.
This will get about 2 and a half feet long and about 18 to 19 pound.
Another time we might target arowana, but today, with the Channel Bill Toucans rooting us on, our goal is to catch a giant arapaima on an artificial lure, something that's only been accomplished by a handful of sport anglers.
Just fight it far from the boat, don't bring it close to the boat because it would jump and just spit out the lure.
Okay.
Rod tip down.
Giant. Oh my God! Jesus!
They will follow his body. Mm-hmm.
He doesn't like that. Get on him.
Welcome back to the Guyana Highlands. I'm Justin Wolf. We're fishing a pond which is part of the Upper Essequibo River system for giant arapaima. And that's exactly what we've hooked. Now, with the help of the hardest working, most knowledgeable fishing guides I've ever been around, we might just land this jungle giant.
He's gonna ride him, I think.
Yeah, have him.
Okay, come in the water.
Come in the water.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not yet. Yeah. Now?
Yeah.
You sure?
Lower horse. Picture first.
Well,
hold him.
Stay. Yeah. Look at that bad boy.
Yeah. Camera.
Push me.
Uh-huh. Okay, see. Gonna release him. It's very strong steel. And this is the way I do it. I grab my hands into the fish mouth and stick this in one of the barber's gloves, and then I hold the other one, and that's simple.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's how I do it.
So you don't, no pliers? Just
no pliers, like to raise up his jaw and
yeah,
keep him from splitting. You might damage your belly or chest.
Yeah. So just caught that big fish. I changed out my leader. Right here I have a Komodo SS from Akuma reel paired with the Musky rod from Akuma. What's great about this rod is when you're traveling, it breaks down. It's an 8.6. Plenty of power for these big fish. So I'm going to put a little croak here on my bait and start again. Here we go.
This is one of the most unique and extreme fisheries in the world, and also one of the most difficult environments in the world in which to run a sport fishing operation. I asked the owner of King William Adventures what motivated her to develop such an operation.
I did it because the young people Dong River was struggling. Most of the young people are leaving their like grandparents, father and mother to suffer alone while the younger ones are out. And when they find a good life out in the city, they never came back. And the old people here is like struggling alone. So the reason I started this here is so the young people could stay at home and support their family.
Here's what I just got that fish with. It's a Savage Salty. It's a saltwater lure, just twitching on the bottom. Some of these lakes are a little bit deeper than the others. So I chose this one. It's about 8 to 10 foot out there, and it's a great bait. We've got some rock out there. It's just twitching over the rock. And that baby just inhaled that thing. Good job, Captain.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.